Like, comment, and subscribe if you end up liking this video, it's greatly appreciated. But for today's video, we're talking about a post by Medler on his quick gameplay thoughts for May 25th. And as such, it reads like this. Pulling the Azir and Ryze investigations. A little while back, we mentioned that we are going to put less time into trying to close the regular play versus organized play divide on Ryze, Azir, and Kalista so that we could put more time into other champs. Before that came into effect, we wanted to try some changes we had been discussing for Ryze and Azir for a while. Those showed some promise, but also looked like they require a fair bit more work to ship, with likelihood of some additional follow-up being needed. We're iceboxing those changes as a result and won't be working on anything for those three champions that isn't just a regular balance adjustment for a while. So just really quickly, what they mean by this is, for people especially that don't watch pro play, sometimes these champions, when they're powerful and you see them get nerfed seemingly out of nowhere, it's because in pro play they're very dominant. Because when they are strong, what they do for a coordinated team like pro players, like, you know, a TSM, an SKT, whatever region you might watch or might have heard of, they're very good. Especially when you look at something like Azir, for example, who he can poke people from a distance, he can DPS people close, he scales into the late game, he can use his wall to peel for himself and his teammates, but he can also use that wall and the way his kit functions to dive and be a form of engage as well. You look at Ryze, who maybe is more in the middle of the spectrum, in which case, for the most part of his kit, he actually is okay for both solo players and professional players, but the ultimate is very teamfight and organizational, you know, play focused, and as such, in solo queue, if you don't have an organized team, that might be very difficult to pull off stuff with that ultimate. Kalista might be the one that's most on the fence, because even with her ultimate, most people by now, she's existed long enough, you know what you kind of want to do or what happens when she ults, so you still might be able to make her work actually even without a duo partner, but she is someone that works best with like a duo partner in an organized team. So that's what they mean by this. There's a lot of champions, besides these three even, who maybe work a lot better and are super strong to the point that they're kind of too dominant in organized play, and it's been hard to balance them for both solo queue and organized play because of that. You know, you look at some other champions in those roles, Victor for example, if he's not overpowered, but he's powerful enough that he can work in solo queue, then he probably also works in pro play a little bit as well. Same with, you know, some other AD carries like Jinx or Kog'Maw, stuff like that. Not that they can't have their overpowered phase or metas where they're just way too good, but they're not dependent on organized play to be good, or else they're bad. And that's kind of the point they're making in this post. This video is going to be a quick video, just kind of asking the question, knowing this and then other champions you might be able to think of, in the comment section down below, let's have a discussion about champions you hope get some work in the future so that way they cannot be maybe super frustrating in pro play and as such have to be super weak to be able to be viable in, say, solo queue, or however the case, the balance kind of works for some of those champions right now. But that's all for this video. So thank you so much for watching this video if you did. Feel free to like, comment, and subscribe as well, of course, but I don't know which video will be next, because life can have a lot of kinks. So until next time, take care. GG, get jinxed. Thank you for watching.